Thank God that you are little one. I may not know where we are, but at least you're still with me.
Either the well was very deep, or she fell very slowly, for she had plenty of time as she went down to look about her and to wonder what was going to happen next.
Oh, little one. Every step we take, it feels like we're further from her. There must be a way back.
I find myself again confined. A day should not matter, but each day feels like waste. There is so much to do. Tamaku tells me that now, with Vitae, I have forever. But the people who depend on me do not. There is always something. Invasion, rivalry, sickness, penury. I have my duty. Perhaps I should end these sessions, now they've found a way to stabilize the disease. I should be ecstatic. I should accept my fate and move on. It is such a faint hope that they can find any way to heal me. That they can find any way to grant my dearest wish.
Now you are eternal, says Tamaku. Now you need no heir.
None of them understand. This is not about politics or securing a future. This is not for the Empire. This is for me. Just for me.
Thank you.
is like... like... it's waking up.
Thank you. sun at the great gate. It tore the air and the land. A corruption of living flesh crawls from the hole in the world and turns all to ash and rust. The control stones have turned against my kindred, shaping them into floating wraiths of nightmare. The city falls. I am to blame. My companions took my formula, some to use it to destroy the Vitae at the gate, others to infect the Vitae pipelines and end the suffering. The gate has indeed fallen, but catastrophically, unleashing energies beyond belief. Still the factories scream. We have failed in the worst of ways. It is my duty to stay at my post, to see if I can find means to end it. I have no choice but to use the Vitae. An ocean holds the great Empress to life, so a meager portion will suffice for me. If any find this record, know that I was the traitor Keita, alchemist, apprentice to Tamaku. Forgive us our folly. Tamaku's early experiments with the orbs summoned an entity, a creature, that scarred the world with its passing and wreaked utter destruction. The scar took the form of living, pulsating flesh. I have studied the orb, and I now know why the scars appear. I believe I can make use of the same perturbation to achieve our own ends. Thank you.
Smoke? That's the town, and the doctor. But how can that be? Something just changed. The air, it's foul. Village. How can it know about them?